I'm going on a... What's up, guys? This is Sarah from Centuries of Sin, and you're watching an exclusive section with the Katurna twins again, Bhayanak Maut. And what we're going to do here is, since Bhayanak Maut is one of the very few Indian bands with a Wikipedia page, we're going to play a small game which may or may not be inspired by Loudwire of Wikipedia fact or fiction. So, guys, I think if you watch the videos, you know the drill. I'm going to recite a couple of facts which we've got from your Wikipedia pages. And you can say if it's true or false and just elaborate on it if you want. Okay? So, starting with the start of the band. The band was formed in 2003 by Jason Lewis and Sriram Sharma, who recruited many members that included Rahul and Venkatraman. But today, Becky is the only original member of the band.
False.
Really? So what's the truth then?
Rahul and Venky are the original members of the band.
Yeah. I thought it was something dodgy over there because they mentioned Rahul, but they don't say that Rahul is an original member.
Yeah,
but
so the stuff if I'm right, it's Jason, Sriram, Rahul, Venky, Sarah Kuto, Ravi Balakrishnan. I think that was maybe one more person. I think that was that Raspberry Rhinoceros show where they played Fruits, Bloody Fruits.
Yeah. Okay, so... So what led to Jason and Sriram leaving and you guys coming in?
Sriram had to leave the country, and Jason and the rest of the band had a falling out. So
ultimately what was left was you two, Rahul and Venky.
No, at that point in time, Sunit was not in the band. It was Rahul, Venky and myself. And then Vinit Barucha came on board. I think he was 16 at that point.
Starting young. Okay. Next one. Bhayanak Maut established themselves in the early days by playing a lot of college fests, which include Oasis Bits Pilani, Red Horizons, IIT Sarang Chennai, Strawberry Fields in Bangalore, and Waves Festival in Goa.
Yeah, sounds about right.
Yeah, what's the first one?
Oasis Bits Pilani.
I don't know if he played. All the others sound familiar. I'm not too sure about Oasis. But not in the early days.
But, oh, in the early days.
But you have played bits like.
We played Bits Pilani and Bits Pilani Goa campus. We played both. We played both.
Okay.
But not as a competing band. Not in the competition.
But just like as a legit part of the lineup, like the individual.
Yes.
Okay. So what is the last college fest that you guys have ever played? Because, you know, with independent gigs coming up, bands don't need to do college fests anymore.
Let's have a weekender.
I think it was SIS. Was it SIS?
I don't remember. I have no memory. I tried to know. I have no clue.
Ooh, the show with Black Star Blues. Kanpur?
IIT Kanpur. Oh yeah, IIT Kanpur was awesome, man. We played 2.5 songs and then the cops shut us down.
Oh shit. And well, then we noise complaint.
Something like that. And we hung out with the Blackstrap guys, Adi and Jay. Like for 45 minutes to an hour, Jay was just like funny as hell, man. It was great evening, man. Yeah, IIT Kanpur. Yeah. Peacocks outside the doors, man.
Which year was that?
I was 15, I think.
Yeah, 2 years ago? Just two years ago. Oh, okay.
Beautiful. Very beautiful.
Okay. Next, Vinay. The band's first gig with you was at the June Rockout Festival in Chennai in 2004.
Yeah, Unwind Center.
Sorry?
Unwind Center.
Oh, okay.
At the Unwind Center, which was in a basement at that point of time.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, man.
So it's like a literal basement gig.
Yeah, it was beautiful, man. It was fun. Thank God, because I had to sing Tool's Parabola. And then finally, so I think my ex-wife Deepa at that point, she had the camera and she was recording the entire thing. So I could play it back to the guy and say, because I can't sing. I cannot sing, so don't fucking ask me to sing these kind of songs. I can't do this shit, man.
Yeah, and also unfortunately, the Wikipedia page doesn't mention how Sunny can enter the band. So would you mind telling us?
I was in a band called Amidst the Chaos with Venki and Amistad.
Mm-hmm.
And we were competing for Swabby Fields.
Mm-hmm.
And Bhayanak Maut and Lounge Piranha were headlining that show.
Right.
And we got through the finals. And Vinay asked me if I would like to do one song with Vinay. That song was Burn.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the first time I went on stage with Vinay. And I think it was a couple of months later.
Mm-hmm.
I was living in Pune, then I was studying.
Okay.
And I got a call from Vinay and he said that we are playing GIR.
Mm-hmm.
We'll be opening for Certificon and I'd like you to come and do a few songs with us if you're looking. I said, yeah, but yes. So I visited Bombay when the night I was leaving. I learned the parts with him. I think on the third or the fourth day, we were downstairs. I think we were just talking. I was on my way out. I said, you should join the band. He said, yeah. And he said, I'll check with the band. And
so your very first show was GIA.
My very first show was opening for Certificon.
That is pretty big. Instead of like joining the band in like a smaller gig, you join a bigger festival. I mean,
and I had known these guys. I was a fan of the band, man. Not like you were best friends, but
mm-hmm.
I knew of them obviously. And Venki and I and Rahul and I were on talking to them. So whenever I'd be in queue at the Raz, these guys playing,
right?
Or if they were just present over there, I'd like this poor fanboy, I would say hi, and then I'd back to my friend, hey, my chanda is
Kamali. Yeah, I think that's what most of us do when
yeah.
it comes to.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm sure you guys have noticed it. I mean, at the Humming Tree, when you guys were performing, a couple of guys were like that. Hi, sir. Nice performance, sir.
Yeah, dude, you were there at the Internaut show. We were like that. You were there at the Internaut show, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so, you saw it. Like, we were fanboying.
Oh, yeah.
Dude.
Yeah, so,
Internaut, dude.
Oof.
Yeah.
What a fucking band.
Yeah, definitely. That's my first time hearing you. What a fucking band. Okay. So, next. Okay. This particular statement has been framed a bit poorly. So, what it says is...
Of course.
That is Wikipedia. Any jack-off person can read it. Okay, so the statement is, they played at the first gig at Raspberry Rhino. So this could either mean that you played your very first gig at Ras Rhino or you played the very first gig that Ras Rhino ever set up. So which one is it?
Mm. Neither are true, I think.
We've done a few firsts. The first metal show at Blue Frog.
First and last.
First and last metal show at Blue Frog. First metal show at the Antifest.
Okay. But Raz Rhino, there's no first. Event.
No, because BM's first show in Bombay was at SIS College in Sion.
Mm.
Second show was at Raspberry Rhinos.
Mm.
First show, it's... Yeah, Sriram was in first show at SIS. I was the vocalist at Raz. So, but it's not there.
Okay. I think I've heard recently that Raz Rhino has reopened. Is that true?
It has. It's now very nice, beautiful restaurant, but the space behind it is open up for weddings and parties and that kind of stuff.
But it's not the place it used to be before.
No, there's a great, my shout out to the guys at Tapped, Rahul, because the Tapped was held at the Raspberry Rhinoceros,
right.
And great beer, and kudos to you guys for doing that. Man. So that was the first thing that Raspberry Rhinoceros did when they opened that. They opened it. Place, and Tapped was held there, great beer, and
I think Sahil cried a little bit. Yeah. I'm sure he must have.
I met Deepthi there, I didn't meet Sahil. I don't know where he was.
Sorry, why was Sahil crying?
Sahil practically lived at the Juru Hotel because he'd always be putting together shows.
Right.
And it's right down the road from, not really down the road from his house, but then it's very close to where he lives.
Right.
So you'd find Sahil in the parking lot being troubled by Abhishvesh and Akshay.
Yeah.
And the rest of the sky guys.
Oh wow, awesome. I think we're taking you to some really old studio.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Okay.
A lot of bands have been formed and split in that very parking lot.
Yeah, man.
Oh.
Like Scribe is holy ground for the Bombay, like the 90s
mm-hmm.
and 2000s, that scene, man. That is fantastic.
So like to your knowledge, is Raz still doing the number of gigs that they used to do?
There is the space that used to be open for the gigs
mm-hmm.
is now a restaurant.
Ah.
So I don't think they're going to be doing, at least the the area where the kids were held, that indoor area is no more open for that.
Maybe
true. Outdoor.
That's another last. The last metal show it has, the one that Werner put together.
Oh yeah, we were there too. Stripe was there, we were there. What's it?
Demonic Resurrection.
Demonic Beer Play.
Got us gagged the previous night and some other
metal. The last metal gig, we were part of that one.
Ah,
okay. Sweet.
Okay.
So that first and last is just got mixed up in the Wikipedia page.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, to be fair, when it comes to like...
Right past us, you know?
Fast band to play.
Yeah, I mean, seriously, people didn't update anything in there. That's the point of this whole thing. Okay.
Right, you must have said, we passed by and played at Radbury.
Fast band.
Oh, boy. Okay, next. Bhayanak Maut got its biggest break in 2007. When you reached the finals of Channel B Launchpad in 2007.
You changed the date, no? This year you've changed, no?
I haven't changed it at all. I haven't even touched it. I don't
know when Launchpad happened. Maybe 2005? When it was in 2005, 2006? Maybe I'm not too sure if it's 2007.
Yeah,
I think it's
2005. That's when Aditya joined the band.
Yeah, 2005. Yeah.
So it was 2005. But the part about you reaching the finals?
Yeah, I reached the finals and... Superfuzz Big Muff won, and then they said there's another band that's joint winners, and that's
I mean that whole time when bands could actually be on national TV, it sounds like a time so long ago. I mean,
yeah, man, it was fun. Yeah.
There's this other band that's been on national TV after that, at least one of the other bands. This band from Kolkata called Shrap.
Okay.
When I mentored them at one of the properties on television, you guys should definitely check out Shrap. They're
two thumbs up for Shrap from Kolkata.
Pretty kick ass.
What's the song called?
No Hope, No Mercy?
Something.
Shit. We Shall Arise.
We Shall Arise.
There was a music video out this. Music video for a song called We Shall Arise. Check it out, it's pretty cool. Pretty groundbreaking.
I think the only metal band actually I've ever heard about that came out of competitions like these was Reverse Polarity. I mean, that's the only band I...
They won Launchpad.
They won the year after.
Yeah.
They won the year after, yeah. They won Launchpad the year.
They won the year after that.
But dude, you gotta check out Shrap.
Pretty.
Definitely. Probably on the hunt for new bands to check out here at CUS. Okay, next, we're going to 2009. When Jero Kavi joined the Bhayanak Maut as your drummer when Rahul took a year off to study abroad.
Yes. So Rahul went to St. Andrews in Scotland.
Mm-hmm.
He did his master's in international business.
Mm-hmm.
And Jay said he would come on board. Rahul asked Jay. They said, of course. And it was great 1 year with Jay.
Mm-hmm.
He wrote Metastasis in that period.
Mm-hmm.
We played a number of shows with Jay. It was awesome. He's a fucking awesome guy.
Mm.
Jay's probably the funniest guy, you know.
Yeah.
he's fantastic concert, you know?
Yeah. But since Jay is as awesome as you just described to him, what was it like when Rahul came back? Did you, was it like a situation like, do we keep Jay? Do we keep Rahul? What?
Jay was understood and established in the beginning that Jay would be with the band till Rahul's not here. Was part of the band, but it was understood that he's going to be in the band for as long as Rahul's not here. Because Jay also has a lot of other projects and he did back then as well.
Right.
And how Jay stood with Bhayanak Maut ended, which is when Rahul came back, is us recording Metastasis. Because we have the songs, like when I said, that we wrote with Jay and we wanted to show something for the time that he was with us.
Mm.
Oh man, I remember. So it was, we were at Bajao. So Dear Name and Chakma for Church were all. Chakma for Church is a song that we didn't put on the Red Album.
Okay.
And and the third song was Confucius. And I think about an hour and a half of jam on trying to figure out the intro to Confucius. We just kind of went out for smoke, and Jay and Aditya were in the room. And 10 minutes later, when we come back, Aditya's like, "Oh yeah, bro." Yeah, we figured out the game. That's awesome. So Jay really, it was just great to be with him. His the way he plays and his vibe is just fantastic. He's worked with us.
fantastic.
Yeah.
Fuck that song, bro.
Yeah.
Fuck that song.
Why?
No, just like that song and your name.
I think the three of us are like, those three songs, and Samita and I are like, I'm going to do those songs ever again.
Wow.
Okay.
Very good.
Okay. So, next, this one's a bit interesting. The Red album, the untitled album, got a 4-star rating in Rolling Stone magazine when it was released, and it is apparently the first Indian metal album ever to get released.
I have no idea, man.
No fucks.
Yeah, then I bet that was written by a UPM fan.
No, even if it was a genuine review, I mean, I don't really not think that. Thank you for your 4 stars, guy. But I have no idea.
Okay. And finally, Vinay, you took a step back from Bhayanak Maut for a brief period in 2010, where you said you would only work on the studio material. However, after a month, you returned and became a full-time member.
That's true, but I returned in a week.
Okay. So what is going on over there?
Divorce.
Oh,
damn. Tough times. Figured it out and came back.
Yeah, because this line kind of makes it look like you want to do something different apart from the band.
This is some personal shit, man.
Okay, fine. So, yeah, I think...
Fuck, so awkward right
yeah.
now.
What? Can we talk about
so
that, please?
Right
You're
now.
So fucking awkward right now, man. This is hilarious, dude.
How am I awkward? Why did I ask? Oh my god. I should probably not have asked that question. Oh no. How do I
I'm naturally courteous.
That's
what
it
is. This guy was like, oh, I'm sorry. Do I have more questions?
I'm sorry, that's the way I am.
No, it's all good, man. It's all good. It's awesome. No,
awkwardness is fine. I moved to Bangalore because I lost someone in my family.
Okay. Hey, no, don't make me. Please don't. I already look so awkward on camera. Please don't give me your entire katha. Okay, and
the one thing you need to know. I'm so sorry to interrupt.
No.
The one thing you need to know is, dude, we don't get uncomfortable for anything. Don't give a fuck. This is awesome. Well done, bro. Well done.
Well, so that's probably the reason why people don't connect with you for anything. Chai tere paas reputation hai, just make the guy as awkward as and uncomfortable as possible. Okay, and with that, we are at the end of this Wikipedia Factor Fiction Marathon. Thanks a lot for watching, and thanks to you guys for making this all of the fun and uncomfortable as I want, more than I wanted it to be. Thank you for listening to Centuries of Sin. If we catch up again with Bhayanak Maut, it'll only be after 5 years. Thanks for watching.
Oh, boy. Sorry, I'm drinking.